welcome back to Rahman Eats. And I know it's been a long time, but I've just been trying to prioritize some personal things in my life and focusing on my health and, you know, stuff like that. So I guess I'm kind of reviving it again after such a long time, with a new place that I just found out about called Azam, Taste of Hackney.
Apologies for that little hiccup. I was meant to say Taste of Kashmir, not Taste of Hackney.
Which is based on Northwold Road, which is quite close to me. I got a few things, and let's give it a go. Okay, so got the chicken biryani with the brown dal, the dal makhni, and they gave some raita with it as well, the yogurt. So without further ado, let's get a good chunk of everything, and let's give it a go. Not bad. You can tell this is homemade. Got those Pakistani flavors coming through. Very mild and very subtle. The actual rice itself is the yellow rice, which is obviously what's done with biryani. And seems like there's all sorts of herbs and spices in here, all complementing the chicken very well. For a standard portion, this is very generous, and you can't really complain. There's actual flavor in the rice itself. Nothing's overcooked. Nothing's under-seasoned. I'm really liking this biryani. And obviously, when you go there, or if you order through Deliveroo, you can make your own box and see what you get. Oh! See some cucumber in there, huh? Honestly, I'm quite pleased with that biryani. Definitely try that out. Now we move on to the veggie chapli kebab. Again, not bad. Surprisingly, it's not too oily, which I'm very pleased about. Yeah, that's veggie, alright. Not too overcooked, it's just right. It's not hard. It's like in the middle of being thoroughly cooked. Just for about right. And they also gave free pakora as well. Let's give that a go. That's very similar to the one we usually have at home. Again, this is Pakistani cuisine. So it's quite similar to Bangladeshi cuisine. Some things overlap in terms of the kind of food we both have. Wow. I am thoroughly surprised with all that is. Okay. So, that was Azam Hackney. Just finished up now. Excuse me. This is actually not a bad place to go to if you want authentic Pakistani cuisine. But I do have a few things that could be improved, which I'll go into in a little bit. First of all, let's talk about price. So, this chicken biryani, initially by itself, $6.50, and adding the diet, it's like 50-60p something. That's additional. And obviously you can make it a full-on meal with drink and everything. That's a bit extra, but as expected. You can also get a variety of other sides, like chapli kebab, like I just had earlier. You can get samosa chaat even, and a few other things. They're on Deliveroo as well, so you can check the full menu out for yourself. But pricing itself, it's a little on the steep side for probably some people in the area, but it's manageable for most middle-class people, in my opinion. But for those on the lower end with lower income, they might struggle a little bit. that's just a personal take on things. So for price with, you know, that kind of perspective in mind, I'd give them 4 out of 5, at least. Quality of food? So the quality of the biryani was actually not bad. First of all, the chicken was soft, it was tender, and it was cooked very well. The rice itself, great flavors, great smells coming through, the aromas and whatnot. It was really good, authentic. Whoever actually cooked the food, good job on them. It was actually quite enjoyable. Also the dal makhni that I got with the biryani, really good. I don't usually like dal, but that one was actually really good. It was seasoned well. The actual gravy with the dal, it wasn't too thick, too thin. It was just in the middle. The consistency was great. Really enjoyed that. And obviously the writer that gave free with it, it actually complemented the biryani very well. Right, the writer was free, by the way. They gave me the option to do that, which is really nice. So yeah, I'd say for quality. Obviously it's not like, you know, like gourmet food, but it's home style food. So for that, I'd actually give them full stars, 5 out of 5, because it reminded me of home, especially my mom's cooking. So it was quite close to that. So for that reason, 5 out of 5, just because those flavors were extremely authentic. They didn't skip a beat in terms of the ingredients they put into everything. So yeah, thoroughly enjoyed that. Also the chapli kebab, not bad. Wasn't too oily, like I mentioned before. That also factors into the score as well. It's really decent for a veggie one. And the pakora itself, also very authentic. So everything was on point. Well done. Okay, so cleanliness. So obviously it was a little small stall stand thing. It was a small shop. That's what I meant to say. All everything there looked, you know, up to scratch. Nothing was grimy or anything from what I could tell from the inside. The kitchen. So yeah, I can't fault the cleanliness either. They're keeping up the standard. Nothing looked out of place. So 5 out of 5 for cleanliness too. Customer service, spot on. Obviously the woman serving me, she was really friendly, welcoming. It's like coming to another family. that kind of experience. And obviously she was very helpful, what kind of size I could get, this and that. Recommended me a few things that I could try. I went along with, what she was recommending. It was quite a pleasant experience. I didn't feel uncomfortable with the exchange at all. I'm sure definitely other people would appreciate that kind of customer service as well. Someone that takes their job seriously, doesn't treat their customers like they're second rate. That's the kind of experience I want in a restaurant and in any sort of food establishment, and I got that with this place. So, 5 out of 5 for customer service with these guys. Really good. Alright, so overall score, with everything in mind, I'm giving Azam Hackney a 4.5 out of 5. Obviously, it's not a full-on 5 out of 5, but definitely give these guys a try. If you want these kind of authentic tastes and flavors coming through, and if you just want home-style cooking from a restaurant in general. Obviously, I got it outside, so when I came back home, it was a bit cold, but that's not their fault because they heated it up right on the spot and it took a little while to get back home. But I'm sure you won't have that problem if you get it delivered to you through Deliveroo. I'll leave a link in the description of all their details. You can find out about them. And I hope you enjoyed that review. I know it was a bit shorter, but that's just my take on things. That was Rahman Eats, and I believe it's episode 10. I know I didn't say it at the beginning, but yeah, I'm pretty sure it's episode 10. I'll double check later. Anyways, try these guys out, and I'll see you in the next one, whenever that is. Peace.